In this video, I want to show you how you can live stream to multiple destinations, for example, Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube at the same time using Restream. This video is sponsored by Restream. More about this at the end of the video. Hi there, I'm Greeny for Greenbox, and as we just learned, I want to show you how you can use Restream to stream to multiple destinations at once. We are going to live stream on Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook, and we will do this by streaming vertical. Why do we go vertical? It's pretty easy because that's the only thing Instagram allows us to do. And as we learned, Facebook is now promoting vertical live streams in the Facebook app. So if somebody is scrolling through their feed and they see your live stream, which is then taking off the entire screen space, the possibility that they will stop and say hello is pretty high. What do we need to get started? On the technical side of things, it's pretty easy. First, we need a camera. In my case, we are using a Sony camera as a webcam. Then on our computer, we need an encoder. In our case, we are going to use OBS. And lastly, we need a Restream account, which allows us to link all our destinations to it so we can stream everywhere at the same time. For every one of you who don't know what Restream exactly is, the simplest way to imagine Restream is the following. Usually when you do a live stream using OBS, you usually have one target. This might be Facebook or YouTube or Twitch. And Restream is just such a target. Restream is then copying and mirroring your stream to other platforms. So once you sign up for a Restream account, which by the way, in the basic package is free, you will have this overview. And as we see here, I already added two accounts. We have a YouTube account, which is my Greenbox account, the one you're watching right now. And if you haven't subscribed, do that right now. As well as a Facebook account. This is my Coaster Picks public page, where I do my rollercoaster photography stuff on Facebook. Just for demonstration, I'm going to add another account right now. So we click on add channel. In my case, I want to go live on Twitter. So we click on that. We say connected. We log in with our credentials. So we give Restream access to our account. And once we did that, everything is set up and we see that Periscope is now ready to be streamed on. Speaking of ready to be streamed on, if we want to stream to a platform, we need to enable that platform in our dashboard. And once you have defined all the target platforms, we can go a step further and we can actually start to set up the live streams on those platforms. You can either do that manually or you can let Restream do the work using their events feature. So in the dashboard, we go to events, create an event. And what this is doing, Restream asks us for a title, a description, a thumbnail, and a time. And what Restream then is doing, they will upload all those informations to the connected platforms. And if those platforms support some kind of events like YouTube or Facebook, they will set up an event. So this means you have a post in your feed, or in our case on YouTube, we have a video box which you can click on so we can inform our followers that we are going to be live in a few minutes. And this is pretty cool because so we can maximize the amount of people who are actually seeing our live stream because they get a reminder before we even start. So in my case, I am creating a test live stream now. The description will be demonstration. We will set it to today. The stream has to be at least 1 hour in the future when you do it through Restream. Upload an image, say test stream, apply. So next up, we can say on what platform we want to create the event. In my case, I want to create it on all the platforms, and we now created an event. And to demonstrate that we just created a live event on the target platforms, let me show you what happened on YouTube. If we go to YouTube and YouTube's live stream manager, we now see that there is an event created, which is a test stream. And the description, this is a demonstration stream of Restream. There is the event, and either you can just leave it and go live in an hour, or go in and edit the description, maybe add some links, maybe add tags, and you're about to go live. Back on the dashboard, you might remember that I was talking about Instagram, and we haven't seen Instagram here yet. And the reason for that is Restream currently does not support Instagram by itself. We need to go over a third-party service to actually connect to Instagram. This is not really a problem because Restream also allows us to stream to a custom RTMP source target. So to do that, we click on Add Channel, and instead of searching for the platform we want to go live, we go down here and say Custom RTMP. We click that, and now we can enter the custom RTMP key we get from the third party software, which is giving us this key. This can be Yellow Duck, or in my case, we're going with promo vgram, and I set it up already. This is our custom stream URL. We go back, enter this in here. We go back again, get our stream key, go back to Restream, enter the stream key. By the way, streaming to a custom RTMP target is not included in the free Restream package. If you want to stream to Instagram and therefore a custom RTMP service, you have to upgrade to one of the paid tiers of Restream. The last thing we now have to do is we have to connect our encoder, in our case OBS, to Restream. And to do this, we go again to our Restream dashboard, and we will be presented with the credentials we have to enter into OBS. So let's do this. Enter the stream key, press OK. And as soon as we hit the start streaming button, we will go live on all our platforms. So there is now only one thing left for me to do, and this is setting up my camera for my streaming on livestream. Hi, that's me, and the camera should be ready. Focus is ready, and we can now go live on all the platforms. So if we hit start streaming and go back to our Restream, we now see that all the services are going online. And another cool thing I want to show you as a bonus with Restream is they have a chat feature which allows you to pull all the chats from all the platforms we are streaming to and present it on one page. And to get there is pretty easy. You go to the menu, go down to chat app, click on chat app, and open it either in the browser or download the dedicated software. And we should now see the chats of all the platforms which are supported. Unfortunately, Instagram isn't supported yet. For Instagram, we have to go back to our third party, in my case, promo vgram, and there we can manage our chat messages, or we just simply open the chat in our app and monitor it there. And with YouTube, the thing is way more easier. We see the entire chat in our Restream panel, so we don't even need the YouTube studio. And the same thing goes for Facebook. Now I can basically go live, and let's do this. So hi, I'm live. This is a test live stream. Spam F in the chat or something. Do that, would be awesome. Yeah, new video soon. New video soon. We're currently live on Instagram too, through Restream.io. And how to do that, that's basically what the video will be about. So that's pretty cool, pretty dope, as I think it is. So thanks for being here in the live stream. I'm just gonna cut it off here and finish the video. The only thing left to do now is to stop the stream. And as soon as I stop the stream in my OBS encoder, Restream will notice and will also stop the streams on all the platforms. Besides the Instagram one, for that one, we need to go over to our Instagram platform manually and stop it over there. So guys, this is how easy it is to use Restream to maximize your potential reach to go live on multiple platforms at once. So go over to Restream.io and sign up for the free base package. It literally costs you nothing. And if you see that the platform fits your needs and is what you need, you can still upgrade to a higher tier and have more functionality. As I said at the beginning of the video, this is a sponsored video by Restream, and this is only the first video of a series in which we are going to present you some features which Restream.io offers, which makes life way more easy if you want to maximize your reach on the internet with live video. I hope this first video helped you, and I hope you now have an idea how Restream can help you and your needs. In case you have any questions, or you saw a feature on Restream.io and you want a video about that, feel free to write it down in the comments below. I will read those comments for sure. And if there is something which is actually a good idea or a nice feature to explain on the next video, I will do that. I really hope this video helped you to understand how Restream.io can help you with your streaming needs. And I really hope you will be here next time when we do another video on Greenbox. All right, so we are on the end card now. You can click two videos here. Also check out the info card, because there might be other videos which might be interesting to you. And there's only one thing left to say. Thanks for watching. I am Greeny, this is Greenbox, and I will see you next time. Bye.